All right, power. Words are fought for it, lives are lost to it. Years are spent wasted searching for it. Power is the most undeniable innate obsession known to man, and rightfully so. Today I want to reveal to you one car that has defined my generation's American muscle car culture. This car has become more than a well put together hunk of metal. Truly transitioned from engineered machinery to stuff that car guys' dreams are made of. I own a pair of Mustangs, a 2003 Mach 1 and an 88 5.0. I'm very much drenched into the whole Mustang scene. And in this car culture, there's one car that stands above all as the reigning king, I guess, of the culture. And this is a 2003-2004 Mustang Cobra SVT. This car was designed by the SVT, sanctioned of the Ford Motor Company, SVT standing for Special Vehicle Team. And they catered to all the high performance needs of the market, I guess, for Ford. The car was designed in a very short burst of time, between mid-2001 and mid-2002, when it finally ended, the production and designing of it. It came after a really disappointing 2001 model year. It was the 2001 Cobra was a disappointment in almost every aspect, performance, legs, and everything. It was getting smeared and smoked by every import sports car in the market. So instead of just kind of tweaking it and re-releasing it in 2002, SVT and Ford decided to completely halt production for the 2002 year and start from scratch again and postpone for a 2003 release. Good idea it was. Designing contest underway, and Camilo Pardo, the designer for Ford, was given the responsibility of creating the new Mustang, the new Cobra. He quickly went underway modeling with clay and computer graphics. He created an all-new style called a refined muscle car, is what they titled it. Everything from the hood, with its rear-facing vents, to the simple side skirts. I'll show you a couple more. The early loading period. As you can see, it's a real smooth, streamlined design. Everything from this, it's all simple, but it has some aggression to it. It's a perfect balance between the two. I think from the way the spoiler kind of just fits and ties into everything. Everything was redone for this: bumper covers, side skirts, side scoops, mirrors, completely new for the 2003 year. It was available in a few different color options, as you can see. Try to include some of each. The torch red, probably my favorite. And probably blue, second favorite. That's just to give you an idea of kind of visually how it looks. Pictures. And after the whole new design was spec'd out and everything, engineering team for SVT turned to the performance aspect, probably the most important part, because that was the biggest disappointment for the 2001 year. They started off just kind of tweaking the 2001 engine, trying to put as much power out of it as possible with little simple modifications to that engine. Well, the boss of SVT, his name is John Coletti, set enough sissy stepping, and he told his team to start from scratch. So they did, and what turned out after a few weeks of more testing and trials and errors, a 4.6 liter cast iron block, 32 valve supercharged V8. I'll explain a little to you what that means. First of all, this car was underrated when it was put out. It was stated that it put out 390 horsepower with a matching 390 foot-pounds of torque, which is quite impressive. But after its release, it was retested and put out closer to like 430. So off the bat, it was an impressive engine. When I say supercharger, it was topped off with the part that goes on top of the engine itself. It forces cold, dense air directly into the block and creates more pressure, equaling more power. See here. besides beefing up the engine, SVP also added to the new Mustang a new T56 6-speed manual transmission, specific for the Cobra. It was meant to handle the added strength and power and produce the most efficient kind of combination. It's pretty fuel efficient. I think it's like 17 miles per gallon on the street and 24 miles per gallon on the highway. Besides the engine and the transmission, the Cobra also received the independent rear suspension, designed to handle much better than a classic solid rear. Let me show you the difference between the two. This is the interior. It's a couple different interior packages. The colors, texture, it was all leather most of the time. What was new was the new suede insert. Let's see, and this is a comparison between the traditional solid rear end. It's all one solid piece. It's really rigid. No real room for flexibility. This is the new IRS. IRS is broken up into two pieces, so each side of the each wheel moves independently from the other, creating a much smoother and more balanced ride. So all these new features made for one incredible journey into head first into performance, backing up all the Team Aggressive looks and design. It's no wonder that the all new Cobra had an instant success with the media, performance aftermarket companies, and most importantly the public, specifically the high performance crowd. Since its 2002 release, 2004-2003, Cobra has kind of rocketeered itself to a place in the Mustang world where not only is it like adored and people are passionate about these cars, any 1999-2004 Mustang with the same basic body and interchangeable parts kind of borrow parts from the Cobra. So you see left and right clones, it's called the clone. It's a regular Mustang with all kinds of Cobra parts put onto it. Really loved by the Mustang community. Another great thing about the Cobra is it's an immense power potential. Already like really strong from the factory, but with a few simple modifications like a bigger supercharger, bigger injectors, fuel pump, and a recalibration of the car's computer, you can go from the 390 horsepower to an easy 650-690 horsepower, and all can be done within anybody's garage. It's all simple work. So defeating almost every single sports car in its market, even at our American muscle cars like the Dodge Viper and the Chevy Corvette, and costing tens of thousands of dollars less, it's no wonder that the SVP engineering team sees the code name the Terminator for this car, because it defeated any challenges to its muscle car supremacy. Now I'm going to show you a quick video just to kind of give you a better understanding of this car and what it's capable of. It's longer than I thought. It's good.